Welcome to DDP. I'm your instructor, Mr. Schwartz, and today is the third lesson in our unit on technical drawing and drafting. Today, we're going to focus on linear perspective, and in particular, one-point perspective. Perspective is the law that when an object is very close to the viewer, it's large, and as it travels back into space further away, the object diminishes and gets more narrow and smaller. Let's take a look at what that looks like. Before we go into anything, we're going to go over some key terms that are going to be used in every perspective drawing henceforth. So first of all, linear perspective is a system of creating an illusion of depth on a flat surface. And what we do as artists and designers is we use the laws of nature that we see around us and we try to recreate that in our art. In this instance, we're creating a 3D space on a 2D surface, a page. And perspective helps us do just that. All parallel lines, orthogonals, in a painting or drawing uses this system to converge to a single vanishing point on the composition's horizon line. And I'll help break that down. So all of the lines in a perspective drawing are broken up into two categories. There are straight lines, which are horizontal and vertical. If you can imagine a rectangle, they are just straight lines. From those corners are diagonal lines that veer towards a single point called a vanishing point. The vanishing point sits on a horizon line, and the horizon line is a line that separates land from sky, and we'll get into that in the next term, which is horizon line. So linear perspective, like I said, is just a system of making an object more narrow as it goes further back into space. The horizon line is a very important line because it determines where the point of view of the viewer is. And it's often the very first line in a perspective drawing. The horizon line basically says where the person is standing. And if they're far below the horizon line, we call that a worm's eye view, where you're very low on the earth and you're looking up. Whereas if you're far above the horizon line, you're in the sky looking down on the earth. And if you're right in the middle, then you're on the earth, okay, standing there. Often the horizon line is in the center, but more interesting compositions are when it's really low or really high. But that's a different story. Anyhow, the next term is converging lines. Converging lines are lines that start at different parts and all come together at a single point. In a perspective drawing, these points are vanishing points. All right. Vanishing points represent the furthest distance away from the viewer. And it's often where the line of sight disappears. So if you can imagine looking off into the distance, the point in which you can no longer see is where the vanishing point would lie. And the vanishing point lies on the horizon line. Okay. So moving on. I'm going to show you how all these lines play out in an actual drawing. So what we have here is our most basic line, our horizon line, okay? And it's this horizontal line that goes across here. And this separates the land and the sky. the bottom from the top. And even though that there's buildings here, it's still the sky. There just happens to be buildings in the way. Our vanishing point, which is this dot right here, is what's sitting right on the horizon line. And believe it or not, all of these diagonal lines, the orthogonals, are coming together at this one single point. This entire drawing is made up of rectangles, pretty much all rectangles of different sizes, thin and wide, and the corners of those are diagonal lines that all come together at this one vanishing point, converge, okay? So you have your horizon line, you have your vanishing point, you have your diagonal orthogonals and your converging line, which come together, and you have your geometric forms, and that's a perspective drawing. Okay, why is it used? It was invented in the Italian Renaissance, and before then, people really didn't have a system of creating a three-dimensional space on a two-dimensional plane. So it was something that was developed, and it was used to realistically portray spaces. Once it was established and made, it became revolutionary. So at the time, perspective was revolutionary. And this is a classic example here. Now we can tell that there's our horizon line, that the vanishing point is right here in the center, okay? And all of these different lines are all converging to the same point here. And then you have your simple geometric forms, rectangle, circles, whatnot, okay? And the organic forms of people are built off that. Okay, moving on. Okay, so this is going to be a demonstration or a tutorial from Project Lead the Way on how to do perspective drawing. This is actually a lot more complicated than what you're asked to do, but what they want to get across is related to the oblique sketching. And what they want to do basically is for you to imagine this form here in a glass box in the same way that they asked you to in the previous assignment, but we're asking you to imagine it in a glass box that has had the laws of perspective applied to it. So the box gets more narrow towards the back end. So that's just an introduction to this. These are different types of perspective drawings. You can have more than one vanishing point, okay? So these one-point perspective starts with a geometric shape dead on and from the corners goes back to the same point. Two-point perspective starts with a vertical line and from there, the two diagonal lines veer off to meet different vanishing points. And likewise with the three-point perspective, okay? So we're gonna move on. All right, here's our one-point perspective. They're all going in the same direction. All right, so horizon line represents the horizon. Okay, we went over all that. Okay, so this is this demonstration is basically gonna show you two methods of doing this shape, which is a complex shape where you have one shape, this L shape, with a second shape, this cube, extending off it, but how to draw it in perspective. There are two main methods that are going to be demonstrated, and they are called additive and subtractive, okay? And they are used in all forms of design and even sculpture and even when you're making clay. Imagine you have a ball of clay, and if you add a piece to that ball, you're adding something, but if you scoop something out, you're taking away. Now, we want you to imagine these perspectives. We'll show you. We're going to go through this, actually. You can place your horizon line. Okay, the vanishing point is there. And I'm going to run through this demonstration. I'm going to attach it to the Google Classroom assignment. It'll be there for you to go back and review. But this is a very long presentation, so I'm going to run through it very quickly so it looks like an animation. All right, and I'm just gonna explain the method. You're going to learn through the tutorials and the videos that I've attached how to draw these basic shapes. But the way that they ask you to do it, all right, is this is method one, okay? You start with one shape, and then you make a three-dimensional cube in perspective by using the vanishing point and all that, single cube. Then you add a second cube to that first cube, and you build it cube by cube, okay? Obviously, the third shape, the third form is twice the size of the first two. All right, so that's method one, cube by cube. The second one, and it encourages you also to add shading to make it from a to make it more of a three-dimensional form. So you can see that that does that. Okay. So the second one, you're gonna start with your horizon line, your vanishing point, same way. And this is starting in the oblique way, the same way that the previous lesson was, where you're gonna start with a larger glass cube first, okay? So you're gonna first draw our rectangle, which determines the height and the width of the cube itself. Once you determine the height and width from a cube, you go from the corners. Even though there's four corners, only three of them go towards the vanishing point. All right, and the three closest, the top left, the top right, and the bottom right, okay? So you're gonna see that being built, and you're gonna see a larger cube being built. Now, once that cube, which encompasses the height, width, and depth of the entire form is made, you're then gonna start carving out the shape, okay, in the same way you were asked to do in the previous assignment. But the added twist is that as you're doing it, those diagonals all go back to that vanishing point. So there's no diagonal made that it doesn't go back to that vanishing point. So it's something added to the oblique presentation that makes it different. So the very first step is you're gonna determine the faces that are pressed against the glass. So if you imagine that this is the tallest part of this form, and that this is a piece of glass and is pressed up against the glass, this here is the part that sticks out the most, and that's pressed up against the glass. Same with this, this is as far as this goes. So this is really determining the depth of all of this, and it's placing these in the correct picture planes, the front, right side, and top, all right? And these three sides, you know, make a difference that these planes are in the right place. So from there, all right, once you've determined that, you're then going to bring all of the corners, lines from the corners back to the same vanishing point, same way. So every time you make a single rectangle, you're always gonna bring those lines back to the vanishing point, always. And to draw the back end here, like here, right here, has to be the exact same line as this. So what you do is you use a ruler and you line your ruler up against this line, vertical line, then move it back so it stays in the exact same angle as that, and it becomes parallel. Moving on. Okay. All right, well, let's go back to that. Okay, so here we have it. Two methods. One was to actually build this first block, add the second block, and then the third block, okay, just like that. The second method was to draw a glass cube in which that these planes here were represented to show the length and depth of it. And then it was drawn in a way where it was sort of carved out of a single block. All right. And this is how our tape dispenser and an iPod is applied to the laws of perspective. Okay, so for the following assignment, you're gonna need a ruler, you're gonna need a pencil, ink, and an eraser. All right, so you're going to download the worksheet attached to the assignment on Google Classroom, okay? And you're gonna use this as reference. This is basic blocks, and I believe I have an example in the next slide. And a horizon line and a vanishing point. And you're basically, this is just an exercise for you to practice making three-dimensional cubes in perspective. And the way that you want to do it first, there's a methodology to it, is to draw the lines from the rectangle closest to you, all right, to the vanishing point. So start with the rectangle closest to you, then move to the next closest. Then once you've made those two three-dimensional forms, you draw the other one behind that one and so on and so forth. So it should start from closest to furthest away. That's the method in which you should approach this. You could try it some other way, but it's trying to save you some time. So it's the way that I have found is the most efficient. All right, so once you have done that, I want you to ink these completed three-dimensional forms and add some shading. Okay, so that's assignment one. This is what it looks like, all right? It's not exactly this, it's something similar, but the idea is that you start with the geometric shape. You go from the corners back to the vanishing point. All of them go back to the same vanishing point. A tip is that when you're using your ruler, you're lining up the corner with the vanishing point, and sometimes you're moving the ruler to a different corner. Always keep your ruler on the vanishing point at all times. So you're keeping the back end of the ruler on the vanishing point, but swiveling the top end of the ruler to meet the different corners. And that's the sort of fluidity that you should have when you're drawing these perspective drawings, okay? Keep that back end of the ruler anchored on the vanishing point, move the front end corner to corner. All right, so that's gonna be exercise one. You're gonna find that on your Google Classroom assignment. All right, so you're gonna watch the one-point perspective video tutorial, and that should help you along. All right, so this is basically just an introduction to this kind of perspective drawing. You're not asked to really make anything, just to demonstrate that you can do it, all right? So there's lots of resources on the Google Classroom assignment, and if not, there's plenty more on the web. If there's any follow-up questions, you can always reach me at the office hours. Shoot me a question on the Google Stream or through Google Classroom. And that's about it. I'll see you at the next video. And until then, take care.